Hi everyone, welcome back. Thank you for being here and tuning in. This week I have a very special guest and a good friend of mine. Her name is Prajakta, also known as Paintastic Arts. She's from India and I'm really excited to have her because she'll be teaching you how to paint with acrylics and it's a hyper-realistic style, so I'm really excited and I hope you'll enjoy this lesson as well. If you'd like to see more of her work, check out her page down below, and also everything she's using, I'll link it down below in the description for you guys. And also be sure to use hashtag ColorByFeliks so that we can see your recreations and share them with my community. And the last thing, be sure to like and subscribe and share to support Prajakta's hard work and this channel as well. All right guys, enjoy the lesson and see you guys next time.
Hey everyone, I'm Prajakta from Paintastic Arts and I'm really excited for this collab with ColorByFeliks. Just to quickly introduce myself, I have been painting for a while now and I paint a lot of hyper-realistic paintings and even scenery paintings. And to know more, please visit my YouTube channel called Paintastic Arts. You will get to see a range of painting tutorials that I'm sure will be helpful for you guys. Also visit my Instagram handle called Paintastic Arts. With all of these things being said, let me quickly tell you all what are we going to make today. It is one such hyper-realistic painting of mine called Strawberry and Wine. Yes, it's a painting and I'm going to give you all step-by-step simple instructions on how to make this one. So let's get our tutorial video started. So we would be requiring a plain white canvas over here. Alternatively, you can also choose to take a black canvas, but I'm going to take a white canvas and paint it with the help of acrylic color and a flat brush. So let's start coloring this white canvas. So a pro tip over here is that you have to move your brush in just one direction. As you can see, I am horizontally moving my brush over this canvas, so I need to be careful that I do not suddenly start moving my brush in a vertical manner. Now that our coloring is done, we will let this dry for another 8 to 10 minutes. So I'll be requiring some more acrylic colors and in today's tutorial, I am using these premium quality ColorByFeliks colors. So white color is one such color which I'll be using the most. So I am going to quickly show you all what all colors we'll be requiring up next. So as you can see, I will be requiring white, crimson red, vermilion, scarlet red. I'll also be requiring some shades of green, so I'll be taking viridian, or you could say dark green, and even sap green. I'm using this plastic plate for my color palette and I'll be covering this with a piece of a butter paper or a baking paper, because you know sometimes it is really hard to wash out colors from your plates, and this is why I think such kind of butter paper or a baking paper is really helpful. So now I am going to show you a hack to make a perfect wine glass. So for this hack, I am going to require a piece of a paper, and as you can see, I need to fold this into exact same halves. After this, I am going to draw a wine glass over it, but of course just a part, just the first half of the wine glass. So once I cut this outlines, I get a perfect dimensions on both the sides. So now I am going to cut this paper according to the glass I have drawn over here. And once I open this, you can see I have got perfect sides for this wine glass. So I'm just making this a little thinner. So the outlining part I am going to do with the help of a thin detailing brush and this white color that we already have in our palette. So now I'm just drawing the outline. Next up, I am going to pour some black color. This black color will also act as my eraser. So as you can see, we have a black background and we are going to do most of our painting in white color. So this black color will act as an eraser to the painting and also help me make some corrections. And now with the help of this thin brush and the white acrylic paint that we already have in our palette, I am going to make an outline of this wine splash, and post this we would be doing some more detailing into it. And as I start to do some more detailing over the splash and also the wine inside the wine glass, I would like you guys to pay really close attention to my detailing. So now that we have completed the top splash part of this wine glass, we now move on to the bottom part, and I'm going to make some symmetric shapes on this glass which will make it look like an actual glass. So these are some shapes that I'm making, and you need to keep following this detailed tutorial. And always remember, whenever you feel like you have done a mistake while doing these fine detailing, you can simply use a black color, as that will act like an eraser. And now, as y'all can see in this previously made painting, there is a vibrant looking strawberry made out of various shades of reds and even green. So I'm going to show y'all what all colors that we'll be requiring to make this strawberry. The colors that we'll be requiring are crimson red, scarlet, vermilion, sap green, and yellow. You could also use a light green if you are not comfortable using yellow, since we are going to mix this sap green with some yellow color. And now let's start making our strawberry. So in order to make this strawberry, I am going to go from dark shades of red to the lighter shades. So the first color that I'll be using is crimson red, followed by scarlet and vermilion. Thank you. dark and this half is light. Next up, I'm taking some green color that we already have in our palette. I am going to use this to make this top portion of the strawberry. Thank you. Next, taking up some yellow color to add some highlights to the top portion of my strawberry. Now that our strawberry is completely ready, we would go back to painting the liquid as we were painting before. So this strawberry just sets a base from where we need to start painting the liquid once again. I'll be creating some bubbles around the strawberry to give some realistic touch. And we'll just keep continuing painting this liquid inside the water. You could refer this liquid as a water or a wine. I would like to refer this as a wine over here, since we are preparing this strawberry inside, falling into the wine glass, so that makes it look even more attractive. Thank you. And now I'm going to take some medium yellow and ultramarine blue to put some highlights all over this painting. So I'm using the same thin brush to put all my highlights. As you can see, I'll be using blue, yellow, and also a little bit of red. Since you know our strawberry is in red color and we need to give some kind of reflection into a wine glass. You all can take a close look of the highlighting I'm doing in blue, yellow, and red color. So our highlighting is completed now, and we move on to the very last step, that is doing some finishing with this black color. And I'm gonna put some more black color for finishing. Thank you. So you can see that the shine of this black color is a little bit uneven on my canvas since the beginning, and I'm going to show you all one hack that is going to help you all see this black color completely matte over your canvas. So what I'm going to do next is simply use my palm and my fingers and keep dapping on my canvas. You can use a paper or like any sort of cloth as well. So this will remove the shine of this acrylic black color. So once this painting is completely dried, you can choose to use a varnish, either matte or either glossy, that goes around your entire canvas board.